toy packaging. It usually sucks. I'm the kind of guy that likes preserving toys they've collected over the years, and that includes the boxes said toys come in. If you look up any action figures on a site like, say, eBay, you'll see out-of-box ones are fairly cheap, while ones with their original packaging are more expensive. I don't really care about how having the box makes the item more valuable, I just care about having the box to go with the figure. Toys are marketed towards kids, and since kids are kids, they don't really care about the boxes their toys come in. When a kid receives a new toy, the only obstacle between it and them is the cardboard and plastic prison the toy's held in. So, with all their might, the kid tears up the packaging until it's nothing but a pathetic pile of peelings on the floor. With the box out of the way, the child can now enjoy the toy. Now, I'll admit, when I was really young, I was like this. I didn't care for the packaging. However, when I got a little older, still fairly young, I started to care more about preserving the packaging of the toys I'd get. This was around the time I got interested in owning video game related toys. I think the reason I liked keeping the boxes they came in was because I did that for video games themselves. The Nintendo DS was my only game system for the longest time, and I never really threw away the cases its games came in. That's probably because the cartridges were pretty small and easy to lose, so their original boxes were usually the best place to store them, unless you were a nerd that owned those carrying cases that stored tons of individual cartridges. Hell, you could store more than one DS cartridge in a box, and there was even a dedicated spot for Game Boy Advance cartridges, but I digress. Basically, even when I was a kid, I liked keeping the boxes my toys came in. Since I was a kid, though, I still wanted to play with the toys, so if the packaging was bad, I had no choice but to somewhat ruin it. At the beginning of the video, I said toy packaging usually sucks. That's because there's a certain type of packaging most toys are put in. That being the kind where you have a plastic casing with flat edges that are glued to a sheet of cardboard with some relevant artwork and branding on it. It's probably the simplest packaging you can make for a toy, and pretty much any other product. My issue with this packaging is, once you open it, you can't really put it back together. The plastic is forever detached from the cardboard, and, because of the glue, the plastic most likely ruined the design on the cardboard. Let's look at a few examples. Here are some Sonic toy packages. I unfortunately lost these figures a while ago, but hey, at least I still have the boxes to prove I had them. This one was Tails with like a blue robot caterpillar, while this was a translucent Espio. Anyway, as you can see, since they're opened, the cardboard's been torn in appropriate areas and it can't be put back together. When I was younger, I tried to remedy this with tape, but it wasn't really enough. The boxes just look crappy now, and no amount of adhesives will really fix that. Sometimes the glue keeping the plastic to the cardboard can lose its strength. In that scenario, the plastic comes off the cardboard without any tearing. Here's the packaging for a Ben 10 Omniverse watch. It was already opened when I got it, but I don't think that was the seller's fault. After enough time had passed, the glue just lost its strength and cleanly detached from the cardboard, preserving the design entirely. Well, almost entirely. Here is an unopened Ben 10 Alien Force watch. It also uses this flat edge design, so I'm never going to open it because it would ruin the cardboard. I already have one out of the box, so I don't have much reason to open it anyway. Let's take a look at a better type of packaging, the plastic flap design. Rather than gluing the plastic casing's edges to the front of the cardboard sheet, the edges clamp the sides of the cardboard. They're still glued, but they're glued to the back of the cardboard sheet. Here, although you're still technically tearing the cardboard, you're at least tearing the backside, which usually can't be seen if it's on display. Since the flaps are glued to the edges of the cardboard, they're sometimes far enough away from any design or writing that could be on the back of the packaging. So, if you tear the cardboard, you're most likely just removing some blank part of the box that didn't contain anything. This is a Ben 10 Ultimatrix. The box has three plastic flaps that came off pretty cleanly, which is good because they were actually glued over some graphics. One thing I haven't mentioned is, although the plastic flaps are great, they kind of have to be accompanied by flat edges. A lot of product packaging has this one design. You have the casing glued over a majority of the cardboard, and the excess contains any necessary artwork and/or writing, as well as an opening for hanging the item up. Let's look at the Ultimatrix again. It has the flaps, but the top of the casing has the flat edge. Luckily, it came off pretty well like the flaps, for the most part. Like I said with the flat edge design, you can't really put the packaging back together after opening it, unless you use tape like I used to, but that can further ruin the packaging, so I would not recommend it. Here, the three flaps allow the cardboard to stick with the plastic casing, which is great since it makes it look more like the box was never opened. At least Amiibo boxes have that one bottom flap to keep the package together. So, where do we go from here? Well, it's pretty simple. Just go with an actual box. Here, we just have a cardboard box that has some parts of it replaced with plastic to reveal the product within. What's great about this packaging is that it can't be ruined as long as you're not stupid. All you have to do is go to a side of the box, carefully remove the tape, keeping it closed, open it, and now you have access to the item inside. Once you've had your fun, you can put the figure back in the box, close the side, and boom, it's like you never opened it. This is probably one of the lesser used packaging types, and that's because it requires more work to produce. With the flat edge packaging, you just get a sheet of cardboard and smack the plastic casing on it. Here, you have to cut out the cardboard in a particular way, fold it up, shove the toy in, tape the sides down, and who knows what else. It's a much more elaborate process. It uses more resources too, so it's technically more expensive to produce. It's no surprise most products don't use this sort of packaging. In conclusion, toy packaging usually sucks. Kids don't care for the boxes their toys come in, so of course companies will want to produce the most inexpensive packaging for said toys. There are definitely other types of packaging out there, but they're either used so infrequently or are specific to a certain product that there'd be no point covering them. Anyway, I like collecting action figures, so preserving the boxes they come in is pretty important to me. There's just something sad about seeing a figure without its packaging, like it's lost its home or something. Toy companies will go with whatever packaging they see fit, but it would be great if they all just decided to use packages you can neatly put back together.